If you're a fan of mid-century modern furniture, then this contemporary take on a sideboard might be just the inspiration you need to build one for your dining room. Hi folks, I'm Chris Marshall with Woodworkers Journal magazine. And what I mean by contemporary here is that most single pieces of mid-century modern furniture were made from just one species of wood, and oftentimes that was teak. But here, we're using two. Solid ash for the upper cabinet, ash plywood for these cabinet doors, and walnut for the door handles, these inner shelves, the drawer boxes, and the base. Why ash? Well, why not? Ash is a fraction of the cost of teak and most other hardwoods. It's easy to work with, extremely durable, and beautiful too. And walnut's chocolate brown color makes a dramatic contrast to creamy blonde ash. This is a project that will get attention. Now the cabinet measures 64 inches long, it's 18 inches deep, and it stands 36 inches tall overall. So it's not huge, but it's got a lot of storage space. These two side compartments are just shy of 18 inches wide, which is plenty big enough for storing a set of fine family china or other larger dishware that you don't pull out very often. The shelves sit on adjustable shelf pins, and these doors slide in a pair of tracks, top and bottom, to keep the design clean and simple. Our 25-inch drawers get progressively deeper. The top one is 5 inches deep, the middle 6 inches, and the bottom 8 inches deep. And they're plenty big for storing flatware, table linens, platters, and so forth. And they ride on these heavy-duty full extension drawer slides from Rockler, so the drawers are easy to hang and adjust. And those slides, combined with half-inch thick drawer bottoms, means you can load these drawers up without any concerns. And you've probably noticed this already, but another cool feature of these drawers is their pulls. They have to be flat in order for the doors to slide past them. So we fashioned them flush right into the drawer faces. Now these start with a cutout that I make with a template, so you can see the walnut drawer box peeking through. Now their shape mimics the shape of the door handles. Then, to make this cutout actually work like a pull, I cut a recess behind this inset area with a core box bit at the router table, so your fingertips slip underneath it for opening and closing. Works nicely. This sideboard might look like a big undertaking, and well, it is. You'll spend a lot of time gluing up and processing panels, but in terms of complexity, it's not a particularly hard project to build, and we've kept the joinery pretty simple too. The corners of the main cabinet go together with mortise and tenon joints, and there are three of them spaced 1.5 inches apart. I used two of my favorite shop-made router jigs when milling those corner joints. This slotted jig kept the mortises on the side panels lined up perfectly with one another and dead straight. And I used this wraparound jig to fit around these top and bottom panels when cutting the long tenons on their ends. It made sure that the shoulders of those tenons lined up perfectly on both the top and bottom faces of the panel, and it worked great. The sideboard's plywood back panel fits into rabbets, so very conventional and easy to machine. And these vertical supports here are housed in long dados in the cabinet's top and bottom panels. And for those dados, I grab my slotted router jig again. All it takes is a larger diameter straight bit to go from cutting mortises on the cabinet sides to milling these wider dados. One jig, two operations. Even the drawer joints are made to be accessible for all skill levels. They're simple rabbet and dado joints. Now granted, these drawer joints aren't dovetails, and so some woodworkers will turn up their nose at that. But if you have a table saw and a dado blade set, these are no-fuss joints that you can make successfully. And they're interlocking, so they're strong. There's no shame in keeping it simple and sturdy. And the walnut leg base won't cause you headaches either. All of the joints you'll need to make down here are good old mortise and tenons again. It's bread and butter work at the table saw and with your plunge router. So if you're looking for a fun build that'll give you a practical piece of furniture for the dining room, you can get all the details about this sideboard in our October 2017 print issue of Woodworkers Journal. And you can't miss it, it's right on the cover. I hope you enjoy building it as much as I did, and thanks for watching.